Next month, the man behind a shooting rampage in Aurora gets a new sentence. He could walk free someday because he was just 17 years old when he pulled the trigger over and over and over again.
And all new for you tonight, one of his surviving victims shares her pain with Denver 7 CB Cotton and her hope that others will listen.
Right around Labor Day 1998, images of crime scene tape and detective work told the story for viewers. Five people shot and killed in Aurora, but one person didn't need the details because she lived through it.
My life has never been the same.
Kayla Reichert was only 7 years old when Alexander Pogosian and Michael Martinez went on a killing rampage, shooting her mom, Penny Bowman, her brother, Greg Medla, and his girlfriend, Marissa Avalos.
I was upstairs changing my clothes, heard the gunshots, came down to the landing where I saw my mom die right in front of me.
Others died that day too. Zach Obert and Ed Morales Jr. were killed at another home and were among the five total victims of what was dubbed the 1998 Aurora Labor Day Massacre. Prosecutors said it was about anger and revenge. The shooter, Alexander Pogosian, was just 17 at the time and was also suspected of killing his accomplice, Michael Martinez, but never charged with Martinez's death.
One person has completely destroyed so many lives and absolutely devastated mine.
Pogosian was sentenced to life without the possibility of parole in 1999 for the deaths of the five others.
He'll never, ever know liberty again, nor should he.
But on December 21st, Pogosian will be re-sentenced. In 2012, the U.S. Supreme Court ruled it was unconstitutional to sentence juveniles to life in prison without the possibility of parole. And in 2016, a new Colorado law meant all juvenile lifers be re-sentenced and made eligible for parole in as little as 30 years. Pogosian has served 22.
Somebody who murdered five people, execution style, and murdered someone's mother in front of their eyes does not deserve to see the light of day.
And Reichert plans on telling the court just that.
For me, there will never be forgiveness. Forgiveness is warranted for people who show remorse, and that's not the case.
Reichert's mom would be 60 today, and her brother in his 40s.
Describe to me a moment in your life where you thought, wow, I really wish my mom could be here right now.
Any event in my life that occurred, you always think, what if I had my mom there?
Now, her life is spent fighting for the ones she lost.
It will never be forgotten, and I'm here to carry on their memory, and I'm gonna make sure that Alex knows that too.
With photojournalist Will Peterson, I'm CB Cotton.
Some people deserve to be in jail and stay there.
Denver 7.